who the ISI is, retired generals and air marshals who they've deployed on Pakistan TV networks to bash India daily, to bash Mr. Modi daily, to bash Mr. Parikar daily. And this country better wake up.
Right.
Pakistan better wake up. If the 100 and so many children of an army public school can be attacked, they better wake up. They've already had about 10 attacks or so since January till now.
Absolutely. Mr. Ram, people are comparing the Paris attack with the Mumbai attacks that took place. Do you think there is a similarity between the two?
It is difficult not to see a similarity. Mm-hmm. Although the two are differently context and perhaps in different situations. Mm-hmm. But there is a certain modus operandi which has to be studied, perhaps to draw conclusions which some people have drawn, that there are parallels. But let me digress for a minute with your permission. I would like to believe that the demographic composition of Europe today has changed dramatically. Has changed dramatically largely because of immigration.
Yes.
Immigration and of course refugees most recently.
Yes.
Now, is it conceivable that a country like France, which is such an advanced and developed country, would not screen those who are coming into France? Is it not an intelligence failure on their part not to see that there are forces which are operating within their own country? Some of these people who have been killed and who have been now caught and arrested are homegrown terrorists, maybe inspired, maybe funded, maybe orchestrated from Syria or from wherever else. But they were within France, within Belgium, within the European Union. So I think this is something which they need to look at very seriously.
Actually, France is one of the most secular countries in the world, especially in Europe, definitely. And they've never really done any kind of, they never believed in any religious profiling. But after this incident, they may.
Well, 2-3 years ago, there was in fact a massive, demonstration which was contained through very drastic methods close to Bastille. I remember that. I recall reading about that at that time. Of course, since my time in Europe, and I was posted as ambassador to the European Union, things have changed a lot. At that time, it was inconceivable that any immigrant in Europe could walk into Europe without checks. Mm-hmm. Today, that is not the case. Obviously, it's not the case. Or in any case, it is not adequate checks. Now, what are we talking about when they criticize countries which have more difficult about getting immigrants into their political boundaries? What are they talking about? Didn't they realize that they are themselves guilty of this kind of a crime? Having got these people into Europe, shouldn't they have monitored their movements, their activities? Well, be that as it may.
Well, in the first case, if there weren't any wars in Central Asia, the refugees wouldn't be here in the first place.
Well, that is also possibly true, but then the French...
who's responsible for
the
those
demography
wars?
Was changing already. It is not just the refugees. Refugees have come more recently. Hmm. But from the mid-40s onwards, the influx continues. And France was one of those... Paris was one of those metropolitan cities which attracted a very large number of migrants. Hmm. And in fact, almost there are certain districts in Paris which are minority-dominated districts.
Yes.
Including the one in Belgium where some of these people are living now. The so-called extremist elements are living there. So all I'm suggesting is that probably there has also been a great intelligence failure in France in the case of this particular incident. Likewise, the incident in Spain, which happened a few years ago,
yes,
was also
Madrid bombings.
Yes, absolutely. So I think
this has been the worst since then.
So there is a message in all this. The message is that global coordination, global exchange of information and intelligence, and really calling a spade a spade. Let's wake up and smell the coffee that this is a danger to mankind, to humankind. It's not the problem of France alone or of India alone or of Spain alone or of UK alone. I think unless we are able to evolve a global system for containing and fighting this, this is going to stay with us for a long time. ISIS is not going to disappear because there are very powerful elements funding and backing them. And till they are there and till this backing continues, they will not be isolated. And once the message spreads in the amongst the radicals in the ISIS purview of operations, then it's going to spread geographically too. And we are in the fringe, as indeed Colonel Butt very correctly pointed out. We cannot afford to ignore the ISIS monster making an appearance in India in a major way, should it not be now in the context of Paris things. It could happen any time.
Right.
We are candidates.
Well, we're going in for a short break. Stay with us. We'll be back after these messages.